सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। समस्तजनकल्याणी निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। ओम पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम्। अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीं अम्ब त्वामनुसन्तधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणीं। यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः। ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनो यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरा सुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः देवाय तस्मै नमः। Having explained the three qualities, moods of the mind, which all of us have been experiencing, but we do not probably categorize them as sattva, rajas and tamas unless until we came to understand what Vedanta is. It is not that when we were young we did not have the mood, or when we were not aware of Vedanta and its teaching, we were not having this mood. From the time immemorial, from the time the human beings and other living beings have been on the earth, these qualities of the mind have been there. But when we come to know that these are the things and these are the effects of these moods, as human beings, we have the choice from tamas to rajas, rajas to sattva. But then, can we ever stop it? Prakriti is not under your control. We all breathe while sleeping, and do you think we are doing it consciously? Blood circulation takes place, body is getting old, cellular mechanism that is working unknown, multiplication of the cell, dying of the cell, rebirth of the cells, hair in the body and the head sometimes when it stops also, but when you are young it grows, nail is growing, skin is changing. Prakriti does its work, you cannot stop it. That Prakriti also is working in the psychological personality of the individual also, as much as you can see constant changes that are taking place in the physical body, so also in our physiological, psychological system also undergoing constant change. To the extent possible, while we are awake into this world, we can choose our actions and attitudes by knowing what is sattvic and what is the effect of sattva. Sattva sanjayate jnanam rajaso lobha evacha ajnanajam tamasa. By the tamas only alasya nidra pramadaha ityadi. So if we want to live a productive life, we have to not only engage in the world, but also engage our mind in the right attitude, with the right attitude. But Bhagavan Krishna here in the 20th verse, we just saw yesterday a little bit. Deha samudvavan etan gunan atitya dehi. Dehi jivaha. Now the jiva now identified with the three gunas, is continuously engaging in any one of the three and usually gets victimized by them. In what way he victimizes? Because badnam karoti, isn't that we saw? Sukasangena badnadi sattva, karma sangena badnadi rajas, and nidra alasya pramada ityadi vrittishu ityadi karmasu badnati tamas. So badnadi, when it is said, bound, conditions, limits. So is there a possible, this is called samsara bandhanam. Samsara bandhanam is not the world is binding you. World is never binding you actually. World is not holding on to you. You are holding on to the world. We are holding on to the world. Is it not true? Is the world is coming and holding you? See, objects are also there. And when we get attached to the objects, it is not object is getting attached to us. My computer is very attached to me. Huh? Is it? My cell phone, I cannot live without it. It cannot live without me. Is it true? It is happily sitting in a showroom. You get attached to it. My dog cannot live without me. It is happily in the place and you got attached to it. So who is causing the bondage? You tell me. World or you? See, if we have caused the bondage, we only can release it. World cannot do anything about it. Don't blame the world. As a sadhaka, in the beginning stages, we think that the world is the cause of the problem. And even Arjuna thought so. Only slowly Krishna said, hey Muda, world has not caused anything. You did the mistake. Prajna vadam cha bharshase. Tadasu na kadasam cha na anushochanti panditaha. So here also, etan treen gunan atitya dehi deha samudbhavan. One who is able to understand that these three gunas are there playing in my mind, but me the one who is able to notice their presence and absence can set myself free. Janma, mrityu, jara, dukkaihi, vimuktaha. One who becomes free of that gunas becomes free of all this. Janma, mrityu, birth and death, and jara, dukkha. In other words, but say janma dukkam, jara dukkam, mrityu dukkam eva. Each one causes a certain amount of pain to us. Swamiji, birth is also pain for the mother, yes. No, but the child, birth is a pain. Otherwise, why should it cry? As soon as he's born, why is he crying then? Again, I came back to the same place. Oh my God. I thought I'm released from that. Now again, A for apple, B for box, C for cat, and D for dog. Start all over again. Dukkam eva janma. Now, but not like the Buddhist dukkam, dukkam, shanigam, shanigam. It's not like that. It is not the world that is causing dukkam, as I said. Janma, janma marana, janma mrityu, chara, dukkaihi, vimuktaha bhavami aham. I can be free of this. When? Etan atithya. Gunan etan atithya. Then what is the state of a person who has released from this hold of the gunas? Amrutam ashnute. Amrutam ashnute means he experiences amrutatvam, experiences immortality, which is already there. As I said, it is not somewhere you have to go. Ye janne ka jaga nahi hai, janne ka vastu. It is not a place to go, it is a state to realize. And this nature of the self, which is always an immortal, eternal presence, we have conveniently forgotten. This ignoring the self is called ignorance. It is not there. It is always there. Come on, tell me who is absent here. So this self is never absent. But yet we never pay attention to that. Whose mistake is that? Yata swakanta paranam. Bhagavan Shankaracharya says that lady was wearing the necklace searching all over the place until she finds it has been with her only all the time. Whom does she thank and whom does he blame? Can she blame anybody for losing it? Because she never lost it. Can she congratulate herself? I got it. Where? Don't ask me. Why? Because I have forgotten. Now whom do I congratulate? I got it. That's why Ramana Maharshi was asked this question. What is that state of realization? It is only to know how foolish I was so far. It is my foolishness which I have been experiencing, my own. Now I realize that is the state of realization. How foolish I was so long, all this while. But then Arjuna asks, how do we know a person has released from this world of these three gunas? Bhagavan is now answering that question. First, let us see the question first. Arjuna uvacha kairlingai strin gunan etan. Atito bhavati prabho kimacharakatam chaitan trin gunanadi vartate kairlingai strin gunan etan atito bhavati prabho kimacharakatam chaitan strin gunanadi vartate. It is written here as three gunan. Stri. It's not stri. Okay. Treen. In my version here in English, in Sanskrit, Kairlinga is stri. Stri gunan. It's not a stri gunan. Treen gunan. Kairlingaihi treen gunan. Etan treen gunan adhitaha e prabho kairlingaihi. Of what kind of external external signs, so to say, by which we know that a person has transcended the three gunas. And how does he move about in this world? Kim acharah? Kim acharati saha? Tasya acharah kim? How does he move about? What is his conduct? In other words, etan trin gunan katam adivartate? How does he overcome this? So these questions are similar to that of, you know, what are the qualities of a Siddha Prajna? Right? Siddha Prajnasya Kabasha Samadhistasya Keshava Siddhati Kim Prabhasheda Kimasida Vrajeta Kim. Similar to that, here he says, how do we identify a person who has crossed the three gunas? How does he conduct himself in this world? And how anyone can overcome this? Very pertinent question. Because such a question will arise only when you know that there is a possibility. If there is no possibility of coming out of this bondage, then the question won't arise. Number one. Number two is, you must have the eagerness to become that. It is not a scholarly wanting, a curious mind. Because a man of the world does not have an intent to ask this question. Hey, Rasatvaya, Rajasya, Tamasya, what? Everybody is the same. So why should I bother about it? So is it not true that one who does not have an eagerness to free oneself would not ask this question? Because in general, people of the world are off like this only. Nobody bothers about it. If I'm angry, I'm angry. So what? I mean, I'm getting agitated, disturbed. Disturb others also. And everybody does the same thing. You look at yourself carefully, observe yourself. You pretty much emulate the qualities of the people whom you have dealt with so far. Either your own parents or your near and dear ones. So we always come to have the influence of the people whom we deal with on a daily basis or regularly, or we were influenced by the people in the early stages of our life. When is the situation where you stand out and say, no, I don't want to be an imitator. I don't want to imitate the world. I don't want to imitate what the worldly people, I mean the people of the world do. I want to do something different. I want to release myself from all this. Such is the case of a mumukshu. A mumukshu is the one who has intelligently observed the world and understood its limitations. Understood his own limitations. And decided, no, this is not the way I'm going to go. So that independent thinking and observation is necessary for any achievement in this life. A scientist, a philosopher, a poet, a journalist, whoever be in the creative field of life would, at some point of time or other, he would have become an observer of life and made appropriate choices. So here also, Arjuna is asking, how do I overcome, or what are the ways we can recognize the person who has overcome this? Now, Gurudev always would say, it is not any external sign at all. It's not that a man of such, who has crossed over these gunas, called guna atitaha, guna atitaha. So, a person who has gone beyond gunas is not someone who has any physical features different from others. It's not that he'll start developing some horns on the head. If that is the case, every day you have to look at what is happening here. It is nothing physical. Swamiji, extra brilliance will come out of your face. Oh, put extra makeup, it will come. It is not any of these external features. How do we then identify? By closely observing the way the person behaves. That's why Kim Achara is put. Look at that person very carefully and observe how he reacts to situations. So that requires us to know the mind of a realized soul. And that cannot be told by anybody else other than the one who has reached there, right? Krishna, when he talks about Sadapragna, he is already a Sadapragna. That's why he is able to talk about it. Similarly, here, Gunadita Purushasya Swarupaha or Lakshanani, he only can talk about, because he has, his earlier also he has said that, they will reach me. Madbhava Madhigachadi, he said before. So here we see what are the indicators of such a man of perfection. So here Bhagavan answers that question. We read, Sri Bhagavan Uvacha. Prakasham cha pravrittim cha mohameva cha pandava nadveshti sampravrittani nanivrittani kaankshati Sri Bhagavan Uvacha Prakasham cha pravrittim cha mohameva cha pandava nadveshti sampravrittani nanivrittani kaankshati. Bhagavan, here Krishna Uvacha said Prakasham. Prakasham sattvaguna vritti. Sattvaguna yena sattvagunat sattvikat prakashaha. So prakasham cha when you put sukham. Prakasham tada prakasha janita sattva janita sukham or jnanam. Pravrittim cha. Pravritti is rajoguna vritti. Rajoguna vritti, and rajoguna vritti leads to what? Pravritti leads to loba. So that needs to be understood when you put cha there. Mohameva cha. Moha, which is ajnanajam, tamasaha phalam. Tasmat, alasya, nidra, pramada, all, ityadi, all of them are included in the cha. Meaning prakasham, pravritti, moham, hey Pandava, all these are all the expressions of the three gunas. Now, a person who is aware of the fact that these are all the qualities of the Prakriti, and earlier he had said in the previous 2-3 verses before, Karmana Sukruta Syahuhu Nirmalam Satvikam Phalam. And also he said, Nanyam Gunebhya Kartaram Yata Drishta Anupashyati. He pointed out that. Yata, when Drishtaha, a seer, Anupashyati, sees Gunebhya Na Anyaha Kartaram Atmanam Akarta Idi Yaha Pashyati. Meaning one who understands gunas are the doers of this, na atma. He is called a drishta. He is a real seer. Which means what? Aham yadi, aham akarta atma. If I am the actionless self, then I must be whom? A witness to what is going on. That sattvika guna brings prakasha. Rajasika gunam brings about pravritti. Tamasik guna brings about ajnanam, loba, moha, etc. So who am I then? This internally watching oneself as different from the activities of the gunas, what does he do then? Nadveshti sampravrittani. When they come to manifest, he doesn't hate them. And when they are there, he doesn't want to get rid of them also. Wow. Maja hai. It is like invited guests or uninvited guests. So when you are inviting somebody, that person brings some more people, you know, would you stop them? Huh. It is said very clearly that a true renunciate either neither welcomes anybody, nor he will show exit door to anybody. It is like I was thinking about it, you know. When you go to a hospital, do they write welcome? See you soon. Do they write that way? Or go to crematorium. Do they write welcome, please? See you soon again. In a hotel, you will see that. Do you see it in the hospital? So what it means, they come, let them come. They go, let them go. So a man who is abiding in the self is not bothered really about their presence or absence. Why? Because he is not involved in their activities. Whichever be the guna is manifesting at any point of time, and accordingly, there are things that need to be done. For example, when you are hungry, are you hating that you are hungry? I don't know why I hated hungry. That is the guna of the body. My eyes, you know what it does? What? It sees. What else it will do? It starts hearing. Huh? My ears, you know, constantly ears. What else? That's the guna of it. You know the fire? Yeah, what happened? It's hot. Buddhu, what else do you expect it to be? Similarly, when sattva-guna is there, then there is a natural expression of it that it is seeking knowledge. When rajas is there is an expression of it for action. When tamas is there, its expression is in the form of a tiredness or sleep, etc. Now the point is, and this, you have to understand this point carefully. When they are come to express in their due time, you must give in for that. Otherwise, you'll be in trouble. If nidra samaye, at the time when the body really requires rest, main sadhak. I won't sleep. What's wrong with you? Bhagavan very clearly says in Gita that a person who doesn't eat or does eat too much is not fit. Yukta ahara viharasya, yukta jeshtasya karmasu, yukta swapna avabodhasya, yogo bhavati dukkaha. One who is able to be disciplined in what he eats, what actions he does, and how he sleeps, then there is no problem. So when it is hunger, you eat. That is the nature of the body. It needs food. No, I'll fast. That kind of a... Unnecessarily, you know, people are thinking that will make them intelligent or better. Instead, they become so emaciated and so tired, they can't do a thing. 9 days, I'm not going to eat. Kiske liye bhai? What did your body do to you? Did it trouble you or you troubling the body? You tell me that. Why you are persecuting the body? What did it do? It's just a vehicle for you. The way you use the vehicle, so will be it is efficient. Why are you persecuting that? Put a hole on it. What is the problem with you? Why are you doing all that thing? So the thing is, in the name of religion, in the name of tapas, etc., persecuting or denying a body's needs is not the way spirituality works. Sattva guna hai, jnan ke liye what engages in it, in the activity of learning knowledge or meditation, prayer, etc. When the need for engaging in the action in the world, loka kalyanartham, manashuddhi artham, ishwara prasa, ishwara arpana bhavena, karma kuru. Kuru karma eva tasmatpam, purvai purvataram kritam, idi kutvan Bhagavan. Clearly Bhagavan has said, do the action. And you understand the purpose of the action is more important than the action. Yesterday also I told you. Eat, but don't be gluttonous. Act, but don't become karmaholic. Sorry, alcoholic, karmaholic. Okay, action or workaholic. Yukta ahara vihara. So when sattva guna is there, or rajoguna is there, or tamoguna is there, nadveshti. He doesn't hate. Rajoguna agya mein jo ka kya karu? Kyu kuch nahi karna hai? Dekho, bas. When it is necessary, engage. If not necessary, just leave it. It'll go. Ye vritti aa gaya mujhe man mein, ye vritti aa gaya. Aapka vritti hai na? Haan. Aapka vritti hai, aap vritti hai. Is it your thought or you are the thought? Yours, when you say, that means you are different from that. Na? When you say your car, that is my car. Not ahankar. It is my car means I own the car. I use the car, and when it is necessary, I use it. When I don't use it, I leave it. If I am the car, then there is a problem. So when the thoughts arise, you watch it. When it is necessary, use it. When it is not necessary, discard it. Keep going. Don't worry about it. The moment you start giving reality to your thought, it will not trouble you. We do not know how to detach that part of identification. So, nadveshti sam pravrittani, when they arise up, he doesn't hate, nor he would do anything to get rid of it. Because they themselves will fall away when you don't support it. He doesn't seek its absence there. So here, that is the sign of a gunatita purusha. He remains calmly looking at the nature of the mind and the thoughts that are arising, and he knows, aham akarta prakriti eva karta. I am not the doer, it is a prakriti that is acting there. That is in earlier few chapters before also, is a guna guneshu vartante idimatva na sajjate. The sense organs are in touch with sense objects. I'm watching it. See, I was thinking about it today. So when you watch a movie, any movie, you know, we're watching. You may identify with the villain, or you might identify with the hero, or whatever it is. But can you do anything there? Can you? Go and change the plot? Can you? So, whatever be the story that is unfolding, you just watch. You are only a witness. You are only observer. You are only looking at the picture, movie. And whatever is unfolding there, it is according to the storyline. It goes there. And some people are not like, Swami, Swami, what will happen? How do I know? Watch. I don't know. I'm not the director of the movie. I don't know. I'm also watching with you only. So, in the same way, mind has its own peculiarities. It will keep producing thoughts. You are not producing it. It is producing itself. So, that detached. So, detached. So, watch with no attachment. And in other words, watch, don't attach. And that is said in beautifully in the next verse here by Bhagavan himself. Not that he watch movie and all, and he says, but he says, Udasina Vadasina. Guneryo na vichalyate. Guna vartanta yityeva. Yo vatishtati nengate. Udasina vadasina. Guneryo na vichalyate. Guna vartanta. Tanta ityeva yo vatishtati nengate. Ud asinavat. Asina means seated. Ud, above. It's like an umpire or a referee who's sitting there and the tennis game is going on. Lawal goes on like. He is also a Lawal first, okay? You love him, you love her, okay? Okay, now start. Don't hate each other, starting with. So he is a person who is sitting there and watching things happening. He is called Madhyastha. Though he is sitting like a judge. Judge is a Madhyastha. Meaning if there is a dispute between two people, he looks at what is the pros and cons of the situation and decides who is right and who is wrong, etc. But a Gunatita, he is a little above that also. He is not a judge. He doesn't judge. Udasina. Upar baitha. Because he is not interested in deciding who is right and what is right, who is wrong and what is wrong. His interest is not to gain anything out of dharma or adharma. Good or bad. Right or wrong. But when it comes to engaging himself in the action, he will definitely take the side of the correct one. But on himself as the identified with the self, which is from the paramarthika drishtya, from the highest standpoint, he is not affected by any one of them. Therefore, he says, yaha gunaihi na vichalyate. By the gunas, he is not at all affected. Is impartially sitting there and watching the activities of the gunas. Like it says, gunaha vartante. The qualities of the objects and qualities of the senses and the nature of the mind, they are interacting with each other. Iti eva, in this way, yaha avatishtati, one who remains, na ingade, it doesn't move. Mu means is abiding in the self. He is abiding in the actionless self. And therefore, his attention does not move away from that oneness with the self. Now, there are two, three points you have to take it from here. From this transactional point of view, he remains detached from what's happening with respect to the world. Why? Because he knows that is the nature of things. See, if I put the fire, hand my in the fire, or you put the hand in the fire, it will burn impartially or not. Oh no, burn, why won't burn for me, only to you? Is it not so? Why? That is its guna. And hand, will it get burned? Yes. Why? That is its guna. Now my eyes are seeing things. All our eyes are seeing various colors, right? It's the nature of the eyes to see colors. Colors and shapes and forms, etc. But now, when I'm seeing white, blue, green, red, yellow, etc. with my eyes, what color is my eyes? My tongue can taste various kinds of rasas. What taste is my tongue? No, it's beautiful. You should understand that. When you abide in your nirguna bhav, then you understand saguna bhava of the world. आप निर्गुण भाव में अवस्थित हो, सो भगवान का सगुण भाव आपको मालूम होता है. हाँ, यू रिमेन इन योर निर्गुण आत्म भाव, देन यू अंडरस्टैंड द ब्यूटी ऑफ सगुण. भगवान सगुण भाव ओनली वेन यू नो, ओनली नो वेन यू हैव बिकम ब्लैंक. When the eyes have no color, only it can see colors. When the tongue has no taste of its own, then only it can taste other tastes. When the nose has its own, no, not its own smell, then only it can smell others. आप निर्गुण में स्थित हो तो भगवान के सगुण को मालूम होता है आपको. आप सगुण में हो तो भगवान निर्गुण होता जा जाएगा. And that is the reason why when we are polluted with our gunas, Bhagavan's nirgun bhav we can never understand. Because we are already polluted with our gunas. You see? When I come to the point of the abiding in the self which is nirguna swarup, then the world will be seen Ishwara bhava. This guna of the Lord, that means guna of the world, is seen as the play of the moods of the prakriti, and you enjoy that. You know, I don't know how to cook. All right, simple example I'll give you. I don't know how to cook, so anybody brings food is fantastic for me, because if I make any complaint, I will not get food. No, when somebody asks, how is the food for me? Excellent. Did you eat? Not yet. Then how do you say excellent? It will be excellent only. See, the peculiar thing is, if I know how to cook, then I am critical about what is being offered to me, right? Hey, theek nahi hai. Aisa nahi karna chahiye. Aisa nahi karna chahiye. So when I identify with any of the gunas, I really do not understand the beauty of the world, the prakriti's gunas. So, guna vartante. Gunaha, they guna qualities are going on. But who can do that? You can understand this. Gunaihi yo na vichalyate. One who is unaffected by gunas alone can witness and observe that the qualities of the world, the objects are dealing with the qualities of my senses and the mind. They are interacting with each other. Idi matva na sajjate, idi matva avatishtadi na ingate. That is the sign of a gunatita purusha. Swamiji, saman he, it's easy, is you know, say, but difficult to follow that. Are prayatan karo na phir. See, we have to make our attempt to abide in the observing self first. Not absorbing self, observing self. Slowly, let us become a witness to our mind. And see, mind, when we say, what it is after all, thoughts, right? And Krishna next puts the beautiful three verses saying that, you understand the movements of the mind carefully. It has, most of the time, it has movements that are going from one end of the spectrum to another end of the spectrum. Joy, sorrow, success, failure, happy, unhappy. You will never stay in the middle. To watch, you want to watch, then you have to be in the middle. See, if you are going for a game, a cricket game or whatever game, if you take a side, you suffer. Is it true or false? Or enjoy, whatever. But that enjoyment is also short-lived. The suffering is also short-lived. Because if you put a goal, my team has put. And next year, why did you do that? Why did you lose that? So joy and sorrow will come to you constantly. In a game which is one day game, they'll be too fast, the Giants are. In a 5 day test match, it'll come aram safe. That's why, no, American and all, they want the games to be over. Within 1 hour, it should be over. They don't want to wait for 5 days of test matches. They can't stand that kind of thing. Everything quick, quick, quick. Is it not true if you take side of one of the teams, then you will have to suffer if the failure, and there is a success, if at all, then you enjoy. Again, there is one side this way, one side that way. It constantly goes on. But if you go to a match and you say, I'm not going to take sides, then you will enjoy the game. Whoever puts game, you will enjoy. Whoever, very good play, you know. Which team you belong? I belong to no team. I belong to the game. So a gunatita purusha is one who is in the neutral mode. Doesn't take sides. So therefore he says in the next verse you see here, samadukkha samaloshtashma kanchanah तुल्य प्रिया प्रियो धीर तुल्य निंदात्म संस्तुति समदुःख सुख स्वस्थ समलोष्टाश्म कांचन है तुल्य प्रिया प्रियो धीर तुल्य निंदात्म संस्तुति। फर्स्ट वर्ड दैट यू नीड अंडरस्टैंड इन दिस वर्स इज धीर धीमान विवेकी। सेकेंड वर्ड यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड इज स्वस्थ स्व आत्मनि स्थ धीर एव ए मैन ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन अलोन कैन बी अ मैन हु कैन अबाइड इन हिज सेल्फ। धीर स्वस्थ विवेकी पुरुष एव स्व आत्मनि तिष्ठुं योग्यता योग्य भवति। वन हु हैज गॉट अ क्लियर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन बिटवीन व्हाट इज रियल एंड व्हाट इज नॉट रियल, व्हाट इज परमानेंट व्हाट इज टेम्पररी, नित्य अनित्य वस्तु विवेक यस्य अस्ति चेत् सः एव स्वस्थः भवति। सच अ पर्सन अलोन कैन रिमेन constantly in the same, and staying in his own self, swastaha na prakritistaha ityartaha. It is not prakritistaha, meaning he is not abiding in the prakriti, he is abiding only in the self. And such a person alone becomes samaha, same in what? Sukha dukkhe sama sukha dukkha sukhe sukhe abhi dukhe abhi dukkhe abhi samaha, same in the joy and sorrow which is experienced in the mind. So with respect to whatever is happening in the form of joy and sorrow, he is able to remain neutral to that. This does not mean he will not have any joy or sorrow. Please understand that. Gurudev very clearly said that joy and sorrow will be experienced by a man of realization also. But at the back of the mind, he has this one thing. Even this will pass away. Nothing remains. So his experience is there, but not reality. Just like you go to a, you know, in the Maya Bazaar or what you call Disneyland, you go pay the money and they sit in that magic mountain or this and that. You know that you are not going anywhere in space. But you experience it. Who stops you? You shout at the top of you, come out, smiling. Kya hua? Bas ho gaya. No reality is given to it. Yeah, experienced. Will you cry when you come out? I was traveling in space, now I came out. You know that it was not real, yeah, but it doesn't stop from experiencing it. And with respect to the objects of the world, is same. Samaha. In what? Loshta, Ashma, Kanchana. Whether it is a clod of, or called of, not called, it's a clod. Clod of earth, or gold, or a stone. Kanchana, Ashma, Loshta. Loshta is a earth. So, whether it is a stone or earth or mud or gold, it is all the same. The gold is valuable to the person who has a value for it, right? You go to a child which is only 6 months old. You have a golden ring and a chocolate. Which one do you think it will pick up? Nowadays, I don't know, but usually... The child least cares about the gold. Well, because that value for the child is more for the candy than the gold. The mother is worried. Hey, the uncle is giving you gold. Why did you take that? What? That's what I want. What? The candy. But the child grows to become 20-year-old. Then changes. So what is the value that you give? It depends upon how much happiness it can give me, right? The gold can give me a lasting happiness than one small little candy. That is a person who has grown up to know the value of the gold. For the child, the happiness lies in what? Not in the gold. What can it put in the mouth? One person, very suicidal, he went to kill himself. And a person, Mahatma, was watching him under the tree, was sitting, and then that fellow went and about to jump out of the cliff. He called him and said, why are you jumping? No, I don't have money and I'm in real debt. Everybody left me. I don't have what I know what to do. He said, okay, wait. Then he took a stone from next to him, gave it to him. He said, whatever stone you're giving. This stone, you brush, you rub anywhere, it'll become gold. What? Yes, try. So he took and rubbed against another stone, that stone became gold. He went and rubbed against a branch of a tree, that became gold. Wow! Yeah, this is a rare kind of a thing, I give it to you. He was so happy. Now I can be rich, I can finish off all my debts, etc. And he was started to go. He went a little far and he came back. He said, why, what's the problem right now? I gave you what you want. He kept that stone in front of him and said, what made you renounce this? Tell me that. That must be more valuable than this, right? If you are able to give me this, that means you have something more than this. So the joy of a Gunatita Purusha is much more than acquiring or honing up any gold or anything. That cannot be material thing. And he does not have any priya or apriya. No dear, nothing hate, nothing, nobody to hate. Nobody to hold dear in his life, nor anyone to run away from. Both shows weakness. Both are weakness only. Possessively holding on to someone is also weakness. Equally, running away from anybody is also weakness. Tulyaha. Tulya means samaha again. And such a dhiraha, ninda atma samstutihi. Whether he is honored or dishonored. Gurudev used to say it is like putting a garland on the neck of a buffalo. Whether you put a garland of flowers or garland of slippers, it doesn't matter to it. It doesn't value himself more, but you putting a garland, you put another garland of gali, you de do. Kiske liye? For whom is this? When I identify with my body, when I identify with my name and fame and position, etc., then I'm very careful about whether I am praised or insulted. Atma ke liye kya hai? He is unaffected by Atma संस्तुति ही वा निंदा वा. That's why भगवान शंकराचार्य says in साधना पंचकम जनकृपा नैष्टुर्यम उत्सृज्यताम. कृपा ऑफ द पीपल ऑल्सो और नैष्टुर्यम ऑफ द पीपल ऑल्सो, praise of the people and censure of the people, both should be understood as temporary. Today whatever is praising you, tomorrow they will turn around. In fact, the person who is closer to you, watching you, observing you, taking interest in you, must be the one who will be ridiculing you. You should take it, because he's doing it for your good. The person who doesn't care, even when you make a mistake, he doesn't notice and tell you, is the greatest enemy. See, many people don't want to go to a doctor. You know why? He's unnecessarily going to tell me something. Are Baba, for whose sake you saying? You know, Swamiji, in my restroom, I have a scale, no? A weighing scale. I never get onto it. Why? Because it also unnecessarily show me that I am overweight. What? It has an intention to do that. You are not ready to take the reality then. So Bhagavan continues here. मानापमानयोस्तुल्यः तुल्यो मित्रारिपक्षयोः सर्वारम्भपरित्यागी गुणातीतः स उच्यते मानापमानयोस्तुल्यः तुल्यो मित्रारिपक्षयोः सर्वारम्भपरित्यागी गुणातीतः स उच्यते. सः गुणातीतः उच्यते. इज स्पोकन एज गुणातीतः. गुणानि गुणानाम् अतीतः. नौ मान अपमानयोः तुल्यः. As it is said earlier, तुल्य निंदा स्तुतिर आत्म संस्तुति. In 12th chapter also he talked about the तुल्य निंदा आत्म संस्तुति etc. He spoke about that also. This sameness in mana, honor, or in apamana, that is dishonor, is same in the sense that not that he won't hear them, not that he won't notice that is being spoken about him, but he understands it is according to their judgment. Their judgment of the situation makes them either respect me or disrespect me. Now, I'll give you this example, simple. I went to some one particular center and then I had a 1-week-long yajna. And then all the day people were there talking to me, Bhiksha, this, that, everything is over until they leave me in the airport. Okay. When they come to the airport, nobody knows me. Right. All are busy with their own ticket and walking there and then they're going to tea shop or eating and then getting into. So can you say, nobody is respecting me? You see this? Nobody is falling at my feet. Ariyom, Ariyom, nobody is saying. If I think like that, I am fool. Do you think everybody is insulting me there? Do I expect them to come and fall at my feet? What do you think? Do I feel insulted when people don't do that? Why do I expect? For whose sake I am expecting it? You know, it so happened when I was in the Mahasamadhi camp, and there was a lady who was serving me everything and you know, doing all that thing. Then when I went to the airport, I changed my dress from wearing this kind of dress to some kind of, you know, because unnecessarily I don't want to become a Christ every time, you know, because when you wear the chippa and then dhoti and all, they ask me to, you know, do this and left all exercises. So I wore a t-shirt and then a pant. So this lady walked past by me, never cared about even looking at me. The same lady who was serving. So should I feel insulted? So what I thought was, for the cloth only she was doing the respect, not to me. Is it not such an unhappiness? ये कपड़ा के लिए वो रिस्पेक्ट देता है, मुरे लिए मेरे लिए नहीं है. इट इज नॉट ट्रू. इफ यू वेयर द कपड़ा देन रिस्पेक्ट, इफ देयर इज नो वेयर नो यू डोंट केयर. दैट इज द ट्रूथ. ये भी कपड़ा है. द बॉडी इज ऑल्सो ए वेयर ओनली यू आर वेयरिंग. द सोल इज वेयरिंग दिस क्लोथ. इट्स क्लोथ्ड इन दिस सोल. सोल इज क्लोथ्ड इन दिस. And soul has nothing to do with this, really speaking. And why does you are expecting any respect for that? So, mana apamana yohu tulya, thinking will make you realize that all your expectations are futile. Mitra aripakshayoho, mitra pakshayoho, aripakshayoho samaha. Whether he doesn't take the side of the friend or he takes the side of the enemy. In fact, the enemy is better because he really tells you where you are going wrong. Any efficient government will have a very efficient opposite party. The opponent should be equally efficient. Then only this fellow will do his job. If nobody is asking, then they will not do their work. So you're always surrounded by Aris. Then you will not go wrong. You're constantly alert. And sarva arambha parityagi. Why it is that? Arambha means undertaking. He stops all undertaking which is kamartha parityagi. Kamartha arambha parityagi. Desire prompted actions he will not undertake. Because any undertaking, according to Krishna himself, सर्वारंभाहि दोषेन धूमेन अग्निर्वारिव्रियते आवृतः सॉरी आवृतः कवर्ड धूमेन अग्निरिव आवृतः सर्वारंभ ऑल एक्शंस आर लाइक व्हाट धूमेन अग्निरिव आवृतः ऑल एक्शंस हैव सम डिफेक्ट्स देयरफॉर एनी एक्शन यू टेक अप देयर इज सम अमाउंट ऑफ defect will be there. When what is the defect? If you are doing it for your own personal wish to be accomplished, it will be greater. That itself is a dosha. But in the worldly action also, there can be certain amount of setbacks or limitations, etc. But when it is said sarva arambha parityagi, here means kamartha sarva arambha parityagi. He will not take up anything that is prompted by the selfish desires. So otherwise, he'll become living like a stone only. So, gunatitaha saha uchyate. So, Arjuna says, sorry, I will have to take a little more time to complete this. So, Arjuna says, Bhagavan, all these are all fine. So, all these things, katam gunatitan bhavami aham. How do I become a gunatitaha? So Bhagavan says, these are all the things of the science of a gunatita. So, you know, one by one, kesab karna, etulya nindatma samstutihi, mana pamanyo tulyaha, tulya mitrari pakshayoho, all these things, you know, Swamiji, it's a lot of work, Bhagavan, to do this. Kya karun? See, Gurudev said, when you have a goal, then all will fall in place. See, you all, many of you have come from India to work in US or Canada, etc. So when you are leaving your hometown and to come here, did you not become a parityagi? You left your friends, left your many other things, comforts of your own house, or home, or your relatives. Aap sab ek bada tyagi ho. How did you become able to give up at that point of time? Of course, you got out of some of the thing here after coming here. At that point of time, your only goal was reach. Is it not true? Huh? Say yes. How did you do that at that point of time? Because your aim is something more than what you have been having at that point. In the same way, Bhagavan says, aim high as you can. And if your aim is very high, the sacrifice also will be high. If the aim is very little low, you don't sacrifice anything. Gurudev used to say, keep a goal in such a way, it'll take a whole lifetime for you to achieve there. Or may not even achieve that in the lifetime. But do that. And what is that? Here Bhagavan says. Now you see. Mamcha yovya bicharena bhakti yogena sevate sagunan samadityaitan brahma bhuyaya kalpate mamcha yovya bicharena bhakti yogena sevate sagunan samadityaitan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. Shortcut to become gunati. What is the shortcut, Swamiji? Tell you. Mam yaha bhakti yogena sevate. Swami, is it bhakti marga, jnana marga you are talking about? You know, every chapter Bhagavan brings bhakti into this. Because the goal must be a totally lovable one. You call it bhakti or whatever you want to call, but that love for the goal is a must. And the goal is embodied by the Bhagavan. The Lord embodies the very goal. If you say, I am in love with my Atman, that Atman is Bhagavan only. So he says, Yaha Bhaktiyogena Maam. Maam means Atmanam. Sevate worships. And what kind of a bhakti? Avyabhicharena Bhaktiyogena. Undeviated. With no other thing as compared to that. Our thing is moksh chahiye. Haan, de do. Iske saath kuch bhi aur de do. You know, what we want is moksha on the way. Like a bhaji hai kya? No, buy this potato also, tomato, kuch aur pyaaj bhi le do. Pyaaj. It is not like, you know, on the way you take it. Exclusively look for me. Exclusively keep me as the goal. Such a person, saha gunan samatitya. He, having crossed over all the qualities of the mind, brahma bhuyaya, to become Brahman, kalpate, becomes fit. See, if you love me, I will take you to Brahman. See the point? Then if you love me, I will take Brahman. Then what is the difference between you and Brahman then? If you are able to hold on to me, you will become fit for Brahman. What does it mean? See, earlier what he said was, na anyaha gunebhya kartaram drishta anupashyati. No. Atma akarta iti yaha anupashyati. Akarta means he is not there, he is different from the gunas. So that is tvampada nishchada artha. What is you? You, the akarta atma. Bhagavan says, if you come to me, huh? Which is usually in Tattvamasi Vakya, Tatpadena Uchate. Tad Ishwaraha Paramatma. Tvam Jivatma. If you understand the Jivasma as Akarta, then you realize Tatpada Parambrahma Swarupam. You realize. Meaning what? Tattvam Eva. The Akarta Atma, if you realize Brahman also. That is the reason why here he says, you come to me, I'll take you to Brahman. Or you become fit for Brahman. And what is that me? It is not Vasudeva Krishna, Vasudeva Putra Krishna. We cannot take it that way. Because that is also an embodied person, a subject to birth and death only he was. Meaning, he was born out of his own Maya, no doubt. But he also ended his Leela. But what we need to understand, mom, here means Atmanam, Brahma. Brahmanam yo abhibhacharana bhakti yogena sevate. One who is able to love and abide and undeviated devotion if he has for that very Lord, who is none other than the manifestation of Brahman. Such an individual is able to cross these three qualities and become fit for Brahma Swarupa. So, avyabhichara, that is very important here. Do not have the goal of realization along with something else. That is, it is called paramapurushartha. Purushartheshu paramapurushartha hai, moksha purushartha hai. Dharma bhi purushartha hai. Righteousness is also a human will. Or human choice. And artha and kama also human endeavors only. But moksha is higher among all the four because these three should be helping you to reach there. Otherwise you get stuck with this, one of the three. And even those who are stuck with dharma, they are also not able to reach moksha. They are just stuck there and then punarabhimananam, pranayajanam, that will take place. Because punya karma will give you rebirth. You can't help it. And then the question is, if I devote myself to the Bhagavan, how is that I'll become fit for Brahman? So that question will arise in anybody who's intelligently thinking. Therefore, Bhagavan says here clearly in the next verse, Brahmanohi pradishtaham. Amrutasya vyayasya cha shashvatasya cha dharmasya sukasya ikantikasya cha brahmanohi pradishtaham amrutasya vyayasya cha Shashvatasya cha dharmasya sukasya ikantikasya cha. Why I said that the devotion to the Lord, me, he says, will lead you to Brahman because I am the abode of Brahman. Aham Brahmanaha Pradishta. I am the abode of Brahman, which is Amrita, immortal, Avyaya, imperishable, immutable, Shashvada, eternal, Shashvada and Dharma, which is eternal Dharma, eternal truth. And it is also the Ekantika Sukasya Pradishta. Pradishta should be going with everything. Brahmanaha Pradishta, Amrutasya Pradishta, Avyayasya Pradishta, Shashvadasya Dharmasya Pradishta, and Sukasya Pradishta. I am the abode of Brahman, which is immortal, immutable, eternal truth, as well as of the absolute bliss. We all seek that absolute bliss only. What else? And nobody wants to be unhappy. But we are groping in the darkness looking for little pleasures in life. But Bhagavan says, if you take one, I'll give you six. Take one, buy one, take six. What a deal. Wow, Swamiji. Yes, new deal. What is that? For sale. Take one, buy one, you take six. That is, by one single abidance in the self, in the form of love for the Lord, will give you Brahman, immortality, imperishability, eternality, absolute dharma and bliss. Is it not such a deal? Because they are not different things. They are one and the same. From different angles you look at it. Brahman, the absolute, is abstract. It is difficult for people to understand the abstract because no quality. Therefore, he immediately puts it, you understand death? Yeah, there is no death. You see decay and perishable? There is no perishing. Is there everything is bound by time? This is not bound by time. This is not an unhappy situation. It is bliss. So from the known, Gurudev always would say, from the known only we can understand what could be that unknown. Because unknown by itself cannot be easily comprehended. Between me and my computer, there is a space. But can I comprehend space? No. So I know where I am and I know where the computer is. And there must be something in between. What is making me able to see the space because of object A and object B? Known. And then through that known, I can understand the unknown. In the same way, we cannot understand the Brahman in its own nature, but we can understand intellectually by knowing that unknown through the scale of the known. Through the measures of the known. That's why he put Amrutasya, Avyayasya, Shashvatasya, Dharmasya, Sukhasya, Ekantikasya, Pradishtha. So in every chapter, Bhagavan concludes with saying the sadhana should ultimately culminate in exclusive love for the truth. Either in the form of a Bhagavan you worship or, have the worshipful attitude towards your own higher self. Gurudev used to say the sanctity of the self should be maintained. Then only the spirituality will grow. If you lose that sanctity for yourself, you will be worse than an animal. The human beings alone can really understand the sanctity of the self, which is enshrined in your own heart. So in this beautiful chapter of understanding the mind, we know how to, recognize the various moods that are appearing in our mind. And after recognizing them, there is no need for us to fight with it. That is the nature of things. But identifying with those gunas, you have a choice. And obviously, it is easier to come out of this grip of the guna when you are in sattva than in rajas. And it is much easier in rajas compared to tamas. From the rajas to sattva is easier than tamas to rajas. Tamas to sattva is definitely a big leap. You cannot make it because both will look alike. A person who is meditating and sleeping will look alike, but they are actually in the opposite. So therefore, from tamas engaged to rajas, from rajas to sattva, and sattva to gunatit. So nitya sattvasto bhava. Then it is easy for you to leap into the state of accepting the gunas without confronting them. ओम तत्सत् इति श्रीमद्भगवद्गीतासु उपनिषत्सु ब्रह्मविद्यायां योगशास्त्रे श्रीकृष्णार्जुनसंवादे गुणत्रयविभागयोगो नाम चतुर्दशोऽध्यायः द 14th चैप्टर एंड्स विच इज नोन एज गुणत्रयविभाग दिस इज द explanation on the three kinds of gunas, modes. So we'll conclude now and I will take some few more minutes of yours after I conclude, okay? Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kaschid Dukkha Bad Bhavet, Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम